we descaled our fish. As you can see here, you can see the skin. It's not quite as shiny as it was. The Kiwa salmon actually has a very soft bone structure, so we can cut straight down and just really rip through them. But many fish you can't. So we're gonna do it both ways so you guys can see how it's done. I like using a clean towel just so it doesn't move on me. Here, I like to slip, but as you can see, it doesn't move. Locate the head, feel along here. The fins will tell you where the spine is. And right here, I'm just feeling where I'm gonna run my knife. And we're gonna come down, we're gonna hit approximately here, we're gonna put pin bones, which we'll cut out, and then we're gonna scoop around the ribs as much as possible. Salmon ribs are very small, very soft, so we might cut through a few of them. If you were to do a rockfish or a snapper, they're much thicker and you wouldn't be able to cut through it as easily and more likely to wreck the meat. So the first step I always start with is from the top of the head, just slowly score along, just barely cutting the skin. And as you can see, I'm just barely cutting the skin. And I want to get as much of the fish as I possibly can, just down the length of the fish. And I can, right here is just a high fat area in salmon. And you'll see as we go down, just go down the length. Ideally, I did a sawing motion. I only want to do that on the skin. I don't want to do that on the fish. Otherwise, you're going to leave a lot of marks on your fish. You want long, straight cuts when cleaning your fish. So from this point, after having gotten through, you see I'm just doing a long, straight cut. And I'm going in pretty deep on this fish. The other thing you can see on the fish is right here is the bone structure. So I'm not leaving a lot of fish on the bones. So I'll start up here again. I'm down to about where the rib cage is. I'm just still going through. Here I know the rib cage is out. I'm gonna come all the way through and just cut down. And you can see the spine here. And we'll be able to see it more as we go through. Pull it back. Cod, you'll find this. And we're just gonna slowly work our way up. This, for a salmon, is not always the smoothest way. That's why the next way we do it, you'll see with the salmon, is so much more effective. Now that I got the initial cut here, put them up here, I'm just gonna cut right around the gill area up into where I'm going. So I can, some people do this first. I like having it attached for the initial cut because it keeps the fillet more stable. It's just a matter of choice. So I'm effectively take where the head is off. Fish, another place that tongues are actually edible, and the cheek. I don't think we're gonna get a big cheek on this salmon, but we will talk about the cheek in a minute. Right here, I'm gonna come through, cut all the way down. So I have my salmon fillet right here. Now I'm at the ribs here. What I'm gonna do is, here's the pin bones. So I'm gonna cut through the pin bones, which we'll remove here in a momentarily. And then I'm gonna follow the ribs. And as I said, salmon ribs are very thin, so. And these cuts, this is the thing that I worry about salmon is. We can trim this up in a minute. Now, right here, it's a little messier than I'd like because we did it. This would be actually okay for a rockfish. This, where it has a little bit of movement. Now, for a salmon, show you we were talking about using the chef knife. What I would do is I would come in here, just cut right through, take off the head. And this gives you the nicest. Find the bones here, the spine bone, and I'm gonna take I'm gonna run down the spine of the fish. I'm going to do this with trout and salmon and some of the thinner bones. As you can see, we've taken a lot of the less meat. I remove this. This salmon belly here can actually be made into a very nice appetizer when we trim it up. We'll just put that off to the side for now. I'm going to pull this fish here, dry out the belly. Looks like when they cleaned it, they didn't quite get everything. That's okay, because we're going to trim that out right now. I want to remove this small amount of bone right here. I want to remove the fin, and I want to remove the ribs here. So I'm going to take my knife, just a little this direction, ideally my knife, and I'm just going to follow. Right now I'm cutting through pin bones. Long, even strokes. Let's go. Hold on. Until if you get hit a bone, you just cut at it. It happens. Some of this there's still part of the gill attached, so that's part of the problem we're having. And we have this fin, so I'm going to take this fin off. Make trimming it much easier. So we still have part, effectively, of the maw, which is what we're getting caught up on here. Salmon belly, as I was saying, if for an appetizer, we can just cut that off and do like a tartare of salmon belly. Freeze it. That way you don't have to worry about parasites infecting your customers. Sorry, guys. All right. I'm not trying to do it left-handed. I'm a little more proficient. Here's my salmon belly. I'll trim that. Move this up. Take this fin off. The salmon or any fish is going to be a little slimy. Keep your knife clean so it doesn't turn in your hand. Trim the fins at the top. Trimming the fish just ever so slightly so I can get the nicest piece of salmon I can. Now these, I find that it's almost like silver skins on meat. Once you get a hold of one, you can just pull it up. Just remove it out. And then we'll pin bone this side. And same process for the other side. So we'll just do the one. Salmon bones are not a good for fumet unless you're cooking salmon in it. They're too oily. You want for your fish stock, you want a neutral, like a flounder, a flatfish, which we do in another video. Trim it down. Just make sure it's nice and clean. The pieces, of the spine, we can run a spoon down here, remove all the excess fat or the meat that we missed, and we can freeze that. And once we get a bunch of it, we can make a sausage. Salmon sausage or seafood sausage. So again, as little as possible goes to waste. Now, what we're going to do is we're going to pull these last bits of spine off. Just cut sideways. Boom. There we go. We got the bones removed, with the exception of the pin bones. I'm gonna flip our friend over here. And wipe down my board. I wanna keep it as clean as possible, even though this is its own mess from this one fish, but keeping the board dry is clean. As I mentioned, talking about tools, I wanna use these pin bone. You run your finger down here, you'll feel all these little bones. They're called pin bones. You just literally just pop them out. One. Just go down the length of the salmon, pulling out the little bones. There'll be one at each. You see these striations in the meat? These little, there's one at every layer of fat, every segment. So it's easy to keep track of them. Make sure you get them all. And you can easily feel them when you run your finger across. It's like running, you know. They'll go down to effectively where the rib cage and the body end. They get smaller as they go. Don't forget the ones in the front. Okay. What I'll do is I'll get this one cleaned up and we'll skin that one. This one we need to skin on for Gravlax. We have here our fillet that we pin boned, we've trimmed down, we've got it to the point where we can start cutting portions out of it. The key thing with salmon is it's, again, is actually high in nutritional value. In many fish, that's where the oils are, the omega-3s, and a lot of times you want to leave it on. But a lot of people don't actually like fish skin, so I could easily cut here and for pan-seared fish, and crisp that skin. For this application, I'm gonna show you how to skin it, which, because we're gonna poach it, and poached skin isn't nearly as nice. So just take a small part at the end, grab a hold, and we're just gonna fillet it down, pulling. If your boning knife isn't long enough, you can use your slicer. It's a very adequate way of doing it, and there we go. I kind of cut through at the middle, but I'll show you how to fix that problem. The skin here. Skin, again, even if you're doing a poached version, you can easily take that skin, crisp it up, and serve it as a garnish. You can serve it on other sushi. Sushi actually have salmon skin sushi. So lots of cultures eat just the skin. So here's our salmon. Right here is the bloodline. This is effectively how the fish moves. They don't have veins, per se, to the smaller cells. They move it along here. So this is where the oil is. A lot of people want to have that removed. Flip this over. We have our fish. We're going to take a few portions. One, two. So we'll poach one. Nudge. We'll steam one on Papiute, and we'll save the, again, saving whole fish is much more efficient